Contestant number 5, Katina Hunter. Hmmmm. Katina Hunter.
Toastmasters, when they swear that they always speak within their time frame. It's the look I gave my husband when he swore he didn't cheat on our diet. Forgetting that I can smell greasy cups from a mile away. The means I don't believe that. The look I've not only given, but I've definitely been on the receiving end as well. It was New Year's Eve. I'm 17. Way too young to be drinking, so I wasn't. But as I'm sitting in the bathroom, I'm obviously caught red-handed. Or was I? You know, Mom, my friends and I ate at Perkins, and my salad tasted really funny. I never anticipated my mother's reaction. I saw something about contaminated lettuce on the news! She marches right over to the kitchen mumbling something about arugula, and at 1 o'clock in the morning has the manager on the phone giving him an earful. Here we are, 20 years later, and my mother refuses to set foot in a Perkins restaurant. Sorry, Perkins. Now my dad, however, he knew better. Bad salad, Mom. Is it even a real word? But he said it all. He knew. And that was bad enough. But knowing that I knew that he knew and I still wasn't fessing up, that was even worse. That was my invitation to come clean. To relieve him of the guilt and disappointment that he felt that I wasn't being more honest in that moment. 17, I didn't know any better. My words are out in the air, so I'm committed to the bad salad story.
Yeah, Dad. Bad salad.
My mistake was a relatively minor one. My sister, however, was the victim of a much larger mistake. When my mom was pregnant with her, full term, she went into the hospital on Wednesday, feeling something just wasn't quite right. After a battery of tests, that something was most definitely wrong. The nurse got her hooked up to the monitors, got her in her hospital gown, and makes the call. And within minutes, that nurse is crying in frustration. Despite her pleas, the doctor refused to come in, rebuked her, and just said, send her home. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, my parents return to the hospital for the planned delivery, and they watch as the staff wrestles the umbilical cord from around the neck of a very blue baby. Limp, but alive. Time passes and my sister's not sitting up. She's not crawling, she's not hitting any of her developmental milestones. Hungry for answers, my parents sat across from the man who delivered her. And he was adamant that despite the fact my mom came in early, despite the fact she failed the test, despite the fact that her cheeks were here, despite the fact that he sent her home, he stuck to his story. He delivered a physically healthy baby. Now, my sister's retardation is not the tragedy. On the contrary, she walks when they said she wouldn't. She talks when they said she couldn't. And she laughs when she definitely shouldn't. give me truth. Now, the truth doesn't change the mistake. It doesn't fix a car. It doesn't cure a hangover. It doesn't uneat chocolate. Mistakes are fuel, but owning them is wrong. Mistakes are human. Owning them is heroic. It frees others of the guilt. It frees others of the doubt. It frees others to once again die in Perkins. Your invitation doesn't come by loud announcement. It lays before a bell. Pursed lips. Slow handling.